Hello everyone and welcome. My name is Marcus and today in this tutorial I will share with you how to design this poster in Adobe Illustrator. So let's go. First thing, let's set up our document. We are going to use a 1700 by 2500 pixels in RGB mode and press create. Next, select the type tool and click on the artboard to activate it. Scale it up so you can see it and write the first word you want to use for this design. I'm going to use yes. We can leave it as the lower caps, because this will be a reference guide. Now with our word selected, let's go to the character menu and find a typeface with a classic vibe. In my case, I will use Apple Chancery. With our word selected, and while holding the Option key on a Mac and the Alt key on a Windows, let's make a copy and then let's write our next word. Now let's select them both and scale them a bit, and go to Opacity and reduce it to 25% and let's lock this layer. Now let's create a new layer and go to the toolbar and select the pencil tool. With the pencil tool selected, let's trace our letters and use them as reference for the proportions. The goal is to make it in one line. And let's do the same thing for the word award. And when you finish, select both letters and right click and choose the simplify effect. With that done, let's go to the toolbar and select the direct selection tool and use it to adjust the points of our line. Now let's make some cool strokes for these lines. Let's select the ellipse tool and design a small circle. Then let's remove the stroke and apply a linear gradient on the fill. After that, let's click on the gradient tool and change our gradient colors. Then using the Option or Alt key, let's make a new copy and apply some new colors. Then let's select both circles and make new copies again. And let's change their rotation so they look a little bit different. Great, now select the top circles and go to Object, Blend and Make. It's not there yet, so we need to increase the number of steps. For that, we can go to the toolbar and click twice on the blend tool to open the tool options. And here we change the specified steps and let's increase it to a significant number and just press OK. If your blend isn't working well, double click over one of the circles and rotate it again until the mixture runs smoothly. And let's repeat the same process for the other circles. Great, with that done, let's select one of the blends and one of the lines and go to Blend and replace Spine. Cool, now let's return to Object, Blend and reverse Front to Back. If your circles are too big, double click over them and resize them. I recommend using a right click and resize them using the Transform tool to ensure they both are the same size. Now let's repeat the same process for the other world. Cool, the main element is done. Now let's turn the guide layer off and make an excellent background for our design. Let's select the rectangle tool, create a rectangle the exact size of our artboard, and right click and send it to the back. And let's apply some nice color to it, and that's it. Now let's add some more text to our design. Let's go back to the toolbar, select the type tool, and write something that makes sense. Or not. But try to choose some nice typography for it, something like a vertical U. And adjust the composition as necessary. Play with the sizes and arrangements of the elements to make sure the poster is really nice and attractive. Then let's go back to our rectangle tool and make some random rectangles to add some noise to our poster. Make it in different sizes and rotations, like over and behind the elements, just to make it fun. And before we go, let's select the brush tool and change the stroke to black and make some scribbles over the design, because why not? And that's almost it. So to finish, let's create another rectangle the same size of our artboard and make it black. Then go to Effects, Texture, Grain, and use the stippled grain at 20/20, and press OK. Then go to Opacity, change the blending mode to Screen, and reduce the opacity to your taste. And that's it. Thank you so much for watching. Remember to like and subscribe, and I will see you in the next one. Cheers. Bye bye.